Is that the only money to be removed, the submission? Why don't we cut across other places, other programs, rather than the older persons?
The Social Assistance Grants for Empowerment, the SAGE program, is among government programs that have suffered an 80% budget cut in the proposed 2023-2024 financial year budget. This social protection program, which the government has been allocating 120.7 billion in two financial years, has had its allocation cut to 24.26 billion in the next financial year.
Employment and sustainable wealth creation, deliberate investments must be made on the people through appropriate social protection interventions across the life cycle. Development is about the people and not objects.
We are really drumming. We are requesting this government, where we are part, we are requesting whoever is taking a decision to cut and send the older persons to grave. Kindly think twice. Think twice. You are condemning these people to death.
Addressing the press conference at Parliament today, members of Parliament who sit on the Parliamentary Forum on Social Protection, led by their chairperson Flavia Kabahenda, noted that with only 24 billion, the government will only reach out to 20% of the 306,516 senior citizens in the country.
Currently, a total of 306,516 older persons are benefiting from the grant across the country. This leaves out 43,000 older persons of 8 years and above who had been registered but cannot be beneficiaries because of the lack of appropriate national identity cards.
Under SAGE, the government extends 25,000 shillings per month to every qualifying senior citizen of 80 years and above. As the government grapples with funding of the SAGE, MPs are instead calling for an increment of the payments to 30,000 shillings and lower eligibility age to 75 years.
That the SAGE should not be removed. Removing support for the senior citizens is like removing food from their mouth. And therefore, a budget that does not provide for SAGE is technically intended to send the already vulnerable people.
How much they have progressed, how happy they are, and all of a sudden we say, your money is no longer there. What shall we tell them? Do we want them to die now?
Legislators challenge the government that it's embarrassing for the NRM government to celebrate its 37th anniversary while senior citizens who supported its way to power are being ravaged by poverty.
The areas people are suffering, these are only 43,000 people suffering in the errors made by government.
Meanwhile, other social protection interventions have suffered similar budget cuts. For example, funding for special grants for people with disabilities has been cut from 16.6 billion to 3.32 billion, special enterprise grant for older persons from 5 billion to 1 billion, and food and non-food items for people with disabilities in rehabilitation from 0.33 billion to 0.07 billion. Other programs include food and non-food items for children and youth institutions, which have suffered a budget cut from 0.64 billion to 0.13 billion, support to street children interventions from 0.12 billion to 0.02 billion, while social development grant has been cut from 7.64 billion to zero.
In Western, we need mindset change. But you provide zero. So how do we set our priorities in this country?
Legislators have urged government to reverse the 80% cut on subventions. Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.